Welcome guys to another video. I recently came across these cheap RGB fans on Amazon, and their price tag made me take a closer look at them. So in this video, I will tell you all about them, and why exactly I think they're so good. Starting from the box, we see nothing. There's literally nothing on the box apart from the brand. Now, these are 120mm PWM fans, and they come in a kit of 6 for $45, making them roughly $7.50 a piece. I couldn't find any data about the type of bearing or CFM specs, but we will test the cooling performance and noise levels and see what it can do. The first thing I noticed when I took them in my hands was just how high quality they look and feel. These look and feel even better than some $15 RGB fans on the market. The housing is sold and the fan itself feels heavy. There's no flex apart from the corners of the fan. Each fan has 9 blades, and they seem to be well balanced when spinning. A downside is that they don't have any rubber pads in order to reduce operating noise and vibration. The lighting on the fan itself is coming from the hub of the fan, which has 8 separate addressable RGB LEDs, and in pair with the semi-transparent material that the fan and the outside ring is made of, makes it actually look pretty decent. We have 2 cables coming off of each fan. We have a 4-pin PWM connection, and this is pretty amazing as a lot of more expensive RGB fans do not have 4-pin PWM connections. Rather, they have some proprietary connectors that goes into an included fan controller or hub that if the hub dies, you can't plug it into a motherboard. While this one you can either plug into the controller or direct onto your motherboard. The second cable is a 3-pin connector for addressable RGB lighting that you connect to the adapter and then connect to your motherboard, assuming it has a 5-volt RGB header, or you can use the reset switch of your case in order to change colors and effects. Another awesome feature is that it uses a SATA power connector that you won't find in any other cheap RGB fan kit, which makes the install much easier and you don't need to mess with the old Molex connectors. Now let's see how these fans actually perform. We will use an all-in-one liquid cooler and compare these fans to the included ones. By the way, we have a review on this all-in-one liquid cooler, so you can check that out also. The testing system features a Ryzen 5 2600X overclocked to 4 GHz across all cores, so we can have a fixed frequency that doesn't affect the results. Using the stock fans, which run about 2100 RPM, and after about 10 minutes of CPU stressing, we see a max temperature of 73.3 degrees Celsius. While running the Amazon fans, we see a max of 72.3 degrees. That makes these fans perform a tiny bit better while spinning at about 1700 RPM, according to motherboard readings. Now, noise levels were a bit different. At maximum speed, the Amazon fans made about 66 decibel compared to 62 the stock ones did, and 63 the Be Quiet Pure Wings 2 make at 1500 RPM. At normal speeds, the fans are really quiet, so considering how good their cooling performance is, we could theoretically make them quieter by optimizing the fan curves. I honestly think that the RGB of this fan looks really good. Maybe not as impressive as these $15 fans that I really like, but they have very rich, bright, vibrant colors, and they all transition smoothly. Maybe adding a couple more LEDs would have been better, but for the price you pay, I think it's okay. So concluding, I really think that in this price range, you won't find any other fan that performs so well and looks so good as these. They are really good, and if you're looking for something cheap that can fill up your case, then I would suggest trying them. I will leave a link in the description so you can find the correct ones because, as I already said, there are some other variations of these. Now, thank you all for watching this video, leave a like if you enjoyed it, and get subscribed for more content. See you all in the next one!